Welcome, fellow scientists. Be here. I hope you've got your running shoes on because today we're exploring science in action. Scientists, they all wear white lab coats, peek through microscopes, and work in labs, right? Think again. While it's true that some scientists work in labs using high-tech equipment like microscopes, many other scientists work in the field, in many different locations, exploring and investigating various branches of science. As we learned in our previous lesson, Think Like a Scientist, regardless of the branch of science, all scientists share a collective skill. Can you recall what that is? Bullseye! All scientists think like scientists using their five senses to ask and answer questions. Nice work! Your studying really paid off! Today, we're going to build on the idea of thinking like a scientist by exploring what scientific thinking looks like in action. Now, you're probably thinking, Bea, what in the world does science in action mean? Here's a hint. You're already a shining example of science in action if you've ever washed your hands with soap, charged an electronic device, observed an insect, cared for a garden, cooked a yummy meal, used a telescope to explore the night sky. The list goes on and on. Does science ever rest? Well, stick around and find out, because in today's lesson, we'll define science in action, describe scientific fieldwork, and explore some of the skills shared by scientists across all branches of science. It turns out, science in action isn't a complex concept at all. Rather, it's as simple as it sounds. Science in action is real people making real scientific discoveries right now in the field and in the lab. Work done in the field, better known as field work, is the process of observing and collecting data about people, cultures, and natural environments. Fieldwork is conducted in the wild of our everyday surroundings, rather than in the controlled environment of a lab, and allows scientists to collect data about the dynamic places, people, and species around them. Whether a scientist is in the field or in the lab, when they put science into action, they aren't just studying it, they are acting on it. For example, the National Aeronautics and Space Administration, also known as NASA, is responsible for collecting large amounts of data to explain how our climate is changing due to both natural processes and human activities. Satellites allow scientists to observe and investigate everything from the impacts of climate change on sea levels and ice sheets to the health of vegetation and the movement of fresh water. NASA's scientists aren't just learning about how our climate changes, they are acting on it. By putting decades of research, technology, and innovation to work, these scientists are actively improving the lives of every person on planet Earth. That, my friend, is science in action. Mic drop. By now, you know that the classic image of a scientist as a person in a white lab coat standing behind a bench of bubbling chemicals is only true for some scientists. And that many different scientists work in many different locations, practicing many different kinds of science. But, regardless of how different scientists may be, they still use many of the same skills to put science into action. For example, scientists are incredible investigators. Driven by curiosity, scientists seek to understand the natural world and improve the lives of every plant, animal, and person on Earth. Their investigations can happen outdoors, in labs, and even in space. For example, in an effort to add fresh food to astronauts' generally freeze-dried diet, our friends on the International Space Station put science into action and designed a vegetable garden known as Veggie. Not only are the plants and fruits from Veggie beneficial to the astronauts, but they suggest that we may be able to successfully grow crops such as wheat, corn, and sweet potatoes on Mars. Mind officially blown! Scientists are also clever communicators. And it's a good thing because the most important step in a scientific investigation is to communicate your results. Scientists have the enormous responsibility of interpreting and sharing the results of their investigations with the rest of the scientific community and the public. Humankind depends entirely on science for advancements in our food, water, energy, travel, communication, health, and other essential needs. However, we're not all scientists, and not everyone understands everything about science. This is why communication is critical, and it's also the reason scientists need to be so good at it. Can you imagine trying to make sense of a scientist's technical data without their help or the necessary background knowledge?
Huh?
Talk about a total head-scratcher. As you can see, there are countless ways and infinite places scientists practice science, and as diverse as their work can be, all scientists share some of the same skills in order to advance scientific discoveries. You can also do these things when you think like a scientist and put science into action! Well, that's our lesson for today. If you are following along, you now know that 1. Science in action is real people making real scientific discoveries right now in the field and in the lab. 2. Fieldwork is the process of observing and collecting data about people, cultures, and natural environments. 3. There are many different types of scientists who work on different types of science. 4. Scientists are incredible investigators and clever communicators. 5. Scientists don't just study science, they act on it. And you can too. Hey, don't forget to check out the engaging games and thought-provoking resources related to this lesson to prepare for our next lesson, where we'll explore science in action. And remember, in earth science, as in life, you rock! See you next time! Hey, hey.